Hello world. So today I want to speak about boundaries and how to feel whether something is a fear to face or whether it's something to not face. And I got my cat here, right here with me. Meet Danahi. So how do you know whether something is worth facing or not? Because I do feel it's a spiritual trap or a personal growth trap where we tell ourselves or our workshop teachers tell you or friends tell you that we should face our fears and we should face all our fears. And otherwise, we're avoiding growth. Had that? Ever been in that experience? Or maybe pushing ourselves, or we're like, okay, this feels scary, so I should do this. Okay, now I'm freaking out, so I'm actually on the right way. Like, I've tried that practice for many years, didn't work at all. So how to define whether you want to do something or not? Well, we all have our comfort zone, and some of us may have the belief that growth is way out that comfort zone, far out of it. Well, it's not. Far out of our comfort zone is the place where we re-traumatize ourselves and hurt ourselves. And actually, by going there, our comfort zone will shrink. And it may feel like you're growing because there's so much emotion on the way. And you might like have strong outbursts of fear, of anger, of sadness. And then when we go back to the comfort zone, we might have this big euphoric feeling, which people, in my opinion, confuse with growth. But basically, in my opinion, what happens is that the nervous system went into fight or flight or even freeze, thought it would die, had strong responses, and then survived the experience and is euphoric because it didn't die. But that still doesn't tell you about which things to face or not. By the way, growth, like real growth, is just outside your comfort zone. Just a little bit outside of your comfort zone, not far out of it. So it might feel like you're taking baby steps, but those baby steps are actually the big steps where you are rewiring your brain and actually giving yourself different imprints, new experiences in life of how life feels. But how to find the difference, which things to face and which things not? Well, my dear friend Jamie Cato once told me when I was going through a really rough time in my life, he said, whatever you do, the next step should be exciting. You know, you don't have to see the end of the forest when you're standing in front of it. You just have to take the next step. You just have to see the next step. And whatever that next step is, it should be exciting. Now, how does exciting feel? Because I think we feel things all in different ways. Like how exciting feels to me might not be how exciting feels to you. You might feel it in a different way. It's a very somatic feeling. It's a feeling in the belly. And the difference is, like, imagine yourself in a roller coaster park, standing in front of a roller coaster and be like, oh my God, this roller coaster is scary, but I want to go in it. But it's scary, but I want to go in it. That's excitement. There might be other roller coasters where you're looking at them and you're like, oh my God. And that's just the whole response is like, oh my God, never. That's missing excitement. So when that's the feeling, and you might not have it with a roller coaster, you might have it. You might have it with bungee jumping. That was a big breakthrough for me. I'm the person that thinks she should face all her fears. And I thought I needed to go bungee jumping at some point in my life because I have a fear of heights and that just terrifies me. And I just have the response in my body that says no. Mm-mm. And I never bungee jumped and I think I'll never will because it's just not exciting to me. It's not. So I won't do it. But what is exciting? And then take that step. That is probably a good bet on still being not too far out of your comfort zone and actually facing something that you want to face. So that's the difference. Is it exciting or not? Is it exciting? You might do it. Is it not exciting? Please don't. All right, sending lots of love. Please share your experiences with me on this topic. I'd love to read your responses. I will read them. I will respond to them. So for now, my name is Ulrike Sophia from exploringdeeper.com. I'm wishing you a beautiful rest of your day. Mm-hmm.